Okay. We should be fine now. That shouldn't happen anymore. As you can see, I'm not doing much in the R&D tree right now. Because I'm so far ahead of everybody. So... let's do the track acclimatization first. And then we'll, go from there. Hit that corner at the wrong angle. Where they said I left body work out on the track because I didn't even touch any of the walls. Perfected first try.
Okay, test complete, and that was a very good job indeed. We got a lot of valuable information out of that.
And now we return to the garage to the race strategy, which I run in lean fuel and no DRS. Because that's how 90% of my race will be.
So far, our fastest lap is a 1 minute 23.0.
I love the Halo though. Looks so good. I just wish it was painted the way it should be. Actually, no, it is black. It is black. I'm looking at one of their cars right now, and it is black. Huh, why is Hamilton so... Why are they all black? What the hell? I don't remember that. They were painted last year. I swear to God, the freaking Halo was painted last year. Did they change the rule on that? I mean, it's possible. I'm okay with it, like...
lap. Try again.
I was paying attention to other things, dammit. That was a bad corner for me. So was that nearly. If I didn't do what I did there, I would have spun it. Sorry, I have to watch the actual qualifying for a second. A 116.040 for Hamilton. Come on, Bottas. A 115.4 by Bottas. Yes! Nearly a second difference between Vettel and frickin' Hamilton and Bottas. Damn. Oh, I'm so happy. Oh, 5 consecutive poles for Mercedes? There's still, you know, 7 minutes left, but oh darn, it's gonna stay that way. What? It's Ferrari's own fault. They build for top line speed. Mercedes builds for downforce. So Mercedes has a faster corner exit speed. Duh. Because you're never gonna beat Ferrari in straight line speed.
Okay, super job so far. We're getting great data. Stay focused.
Even Mercedes knows that. Like, you're not gonna beat Ferrari on straight line. And it looks like Leclerc is having some sort of mechanical issue or something. feel bad for Leclerc because, like, he was actually getting really good last year with Alpha. And now it feels like he's getting just heartbreak after heartbreak this year so far.
Great lap. You nailed what we asked for. Keep it up.
Oh, wow. If any of you have seen me play the Crew 2, you know that I run the Mercedes paint scheme on my 2018 F1 car. I just realized that my paint scheme is actually accurate, but it's accurate for this year's Mercedes car, for the 2019 car, not the 2018. So it is accurate, it's just for the wrong year. So we had that hiccup on the first lap, and then a really, really smooth rest of the lap. The only thing I could see myself needing to change would be the downforce in that last corner. But I don't know if I would put more downforce, so raising it, or lowering it. Like, I don't understand how that all works. Because I'm not a car guy, so that's why I don't tend to mess with a lot of the defaults and just kind of leave them.
Laps of fuel remaining.
I'm doing exactly how you're supposed to do that chicane, and it just doesn't feel fast enough.
Our best lap so far is a 1:21.1.
Alright. The only thing that lacked was that one. Otherwise, I was good across the board, and I'm quite happy with the run, so I'm going to move to qualifying now.
An interesting practice session there, then. Let's remind ourselves of the top three, who are the captain, Hamilton, and Sebastian Vettel. Thank you for joining us for free practice today.
So.
Great workout there today. How do you think it went? You really put a lot of effort into practice today. Are you testing new components? You had the fastest time in practice. Will we see similar times in qualifying? Great. Well, that's everything.
Nope, it's it's still chugging there. I don't know why. I mean, it's not too terrible. Just over 1,000 now. It chugs there on consoles too. Huh. Weird. I wonder why though. Cool, so we're looking at dry conditions for another race weekend. Yeah, probably, yeah. Because it chugs at the end of the race too. When it's showing all the different people and all the people around the drivers and everything. And it's almost a second gap. Yeah, that's gonna be really cool. Moving up from F2, that's gonna be amazing. That's gonna be so much fun. And way to go, Bottas and Hamilton, once again for another 1-2 front row start for tomorrow's race. That's 5 races in a row. And where Ferrari's really gonna suffer with this straight line speed shit is next weekend. Or not next weekend, but the following weekend. And the confirmed team orders in story will make your career less of a chore. Ooh, that's gonna be interesting. I didn't hear about the whole team order thing. Oh, wow. That's gonna be cool. How the hell is Ferrari ever gonna compete with Mercedes, who's a downforce heavy team now? At Monaco? With Ferrari being straight line speed? At Monaco being tight corners and left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right? Very, very quickly? They're not! Ferrari ain't got a prayer next when we go to Monaco. They have no chance.
Today's qualifying session is about to start here at the Circuit de Barcelona, Catalunya. And what a cracker of a session we're expecting it to be.
I just hope that with the team order thing, I just hope it's not going to be one of those things where I'm going to have to give up a win. You know? I'm pleased with Bottas, and I'm very pleased with Leclerc and how he's been. Because Leclerc is a good racer. Look at, like, perfect example, Bahrain. He could have made a big issue out of that. When Mercedes got up to him. He could have made an issue and tried to block and everything else. But he didn't. Which made me see a lot more respect out of him where he got a lot more respect out of me because of that. Because, like, that's how you're supposed to race. The way Vettel races people, I can't stand. Bottas is doing great. My favorite drivers will always be the top two Mercedes, and then Leclerc is starting to fall into that group. So is Verstappen, because I've seen a change of character for Verstappen over the last couple of years. From him being the little prick he was when he started to this year, he's definitely improved himself. God damn it. And the auto moderator, I do apologize for that. I will fix that. Right now. I'm gonna fix that right now. Give me a moment. Oofed. Yeah. I know. I'm trying to... Okay. So, that should fix the problem now. So that shouldn't happen anymore. Basically, what I had to do is go into my Stream Elements website and basically adjust a couple things, turn some stuff off.
There's only one lap of fuel remaining.
Devs say you have the option to listen to or refuse your team orders, which will affect your relationship with your team and teammate in a cutscene. Oh, cool. That's freaking cool as shit. That's gonna be great when it comes to, you know, the future of the franchise and everything else. Like, and this is where I say again, you want it? 2019? Expect there to be some bugs. Expect there to be some issues. And the reason why I say that, every other year, or their odd years, such as F1 2019, are the years where I say they always test it by new features.
Our best lap so far is a 1:20.1.
Such as, like, for example, the bring back of the classic cars. When was that? 2017. Did it work? Was 2017 the greatest game? No. But 2018 is vastly superior. So, you know, don't expect 2019 to be perfect. Oh, wow, how the hell is that gonna happen? Yeah, I'm fully expecting some issues that should be fixed in the future. Oh yeah, definitely. Definitely. Like, I've always expected them to fix things. I shouldn't need to run another lap. See, he's beating me in the last sector. That's where they're all beating me. The last sector. That last corner. So that's where I'll lose a little bit of time. No big deal. So basically, you're going to have a rivalry with an F2 driver to basically determine if you keep your seat or not. The only thing I worry about is me not being able to get with Mercedes with 2019. That's the only thing I worry about, because like, this has always been the team I've raced with. It's the team I feel comfortable with, it's the team that I like, who I work with as a teammate. Also, 2019 is also going to add a lot more work for us veterans who like to keep up with the F1 series through the normal season, because we're going to have to bust our ass to catch up. Because having to fight through F2 is going to delay that process a little bit.
Just put in the fastest lap. Good job.
I'm still like 4 seconds slower than the current cars. Shouldn't need to run another lap. Yeah, I easily got it locked up. Like I said, normally with qualifying, I run one lap each session. One lap and I'm good. I will read that message in a moment. a nice, clean, open racetrack in front of me. Nothing to hinder me. I mean, my teammates up here, but... he should stay relatively in front of me. Look at that, Vettel with a 121, and I'm 2 seconds faster than him right now.
Lap so far. Well done.
What I'm gonna try to do is I'm gonna try to do this. I'm gonna run one more lap around, but I'm gonna do another flying lap and try to do it directly after that, so hopefully some guys will come in pitted and I now have some breathing space in front of me. Oh! Or I have the whole track clear to me.
Two laps of fuel remaining.
Feels like something's not adding up. That was a lot smoother corner. Also, there will be different schools in F2. We're not 100% sure yet of how it works, because if you choose Mercedes, you have the possibility of ending up at Force India.
Our best lap so far is a 118.9.
My guess is it is determined by how well you do, and I don't doubt they'll allow you to switch teams or just choose which team you go into after F2. I hope at some point in the future Codemasters gets the rights to allow drivers to join other teams, so at some point you could possibly see Vettel in Mercedes or Hamilton in Ferrari. I would love to see that. I would love to see that, because it's freaking also Alonso in P2. If only that happened in 2018. Is he really P2? What the fuck? That's hilarious. Oh my god. That's actually hilarious.
So qualifying is complete. Ah, we're all set
beat him
up.
I knew
tomorrow.
He would.
Your top three.
That's fucking funny.
The captain, Hamilton,
it gets worse
though.
I've had
four
CDO up podium twice this
now,
year.
But we'll
season.
Be back tomorrow when the Grand Prix itself
twice.
Gets underway.
GP2 engine. Yeah, they must have. I've had four CDO freaking second and third, or third in two of my races. So, like, I've had really good success with, my driver, with, my career. Now, you're damn right I'm racing on hard, but, like, you can see that if I went any higher, it'd be even too hard for me to be able to compete with the way I race. So, like, the difficulty is actually perfect where it is. To be fair, Force India are pretty good if they would play to the advantage of Mercedes' engine. Oh, yeah. I totally agree with you on that. Although, I thought Force India was Red Bull or something like that, or a separate entity of one of them. But I didn't think that they were a separate entity of Mercedes. Because I always thought the separate entity to Mercedes was Williams, and that was it. Because I know, okay, I know the secondary for the Red Bull team is Toro Rosso. Ferrari's got Alpha. Ferrari also powers Haas. Renault is powered by Renault engines, or whatever engine they use, I don't remember. McLaren's powered by an engine. So I guess, yeah, that would make sense.
Well done. Very solid results. You're looking good for the race.
Alrighty. Yeah, we'll do that durability upgrade. Yeah, look at that. So that way then my durability is all at 2 on everything. So then it's just maxing it out. So. Alrighty. Be ready for a long race. Ugh! How to have two Red Bull teams without calling them both Red Bulls? Let's name it Toro Rosso, which is Red Bull and Latina in Italian. I knew that! I freaking knew that! I'm like, wait a minute, Toro Rosso is Red Bull.
What does the Spanish Grand Prix have in store for us today, I wonder? I hope we see some tight wheel-to-wheel action down the main straight.
Different paint scheme, different name. You know, they add on. But when you, when you do a translation of Toro Rosso, it translates to Red Bull, and it's like, wait a minute.
The circuit to Barcelona, Catalunya, then. A high-speed 2.89-mile circuit, which demands an efficient downforce package and bravery on the part of the driver, especially through the blind right of Turn 9, which we might just see taken flat this weekend.
Why do they say it's a blind right? That doesn't make sense. There's the flyover that I love so very much.
With that then, let's run through the grid order. The captain lines up on pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have
but
Alonso,
seriously,
Verstappen
is a douche.
Daniel Ricciardo, and Vettel, Perez, Ocon, Sainz, and Nico Hülkenberg.
Go back and look at what he did last
Stoffel,
weekend.
Van Dorn, and
because
Magnussen,
he did give way.
Gasly, Leclerc,
he did give way
and
to Vettel.
Sirotkin
or whoever it was, he did give way to someone the last race prior to Spain, which means that he learned something from the spin that he had with the driver, because it was a Force India driver that he let go by him. He learned his lesson, so he's learning. You gotta give the guy a few years. Like I bashed him at first too, to be fair. When I saw some of the things he was doing, I hated him. I absolutely hated him. But let him grow a little bit. You know, look at Lewis and look at, you know, how much he's grown over the years.
Let's get the car up to temperature on this lap. We're learning the gears, so go through them all if you can.
I like doing the formation lap though. You'll notice very quickly I will pull away, kind of quickly. I am gonna try to race this a little differently because I do have reduced damage turned on.
No threat of rain for the time being. Conditions looking good.
So I do want to race this differently so I don't damage my car. To be honest, I'm always happy when someone other than Lewis or Sebastian get first place, so I don't have to hear, "Get in there, Lewis," or "Grazie, Ragazzi," for the Ferrari. Huh. Yeah. Hey. I'm very happy to see Bottas winning. The way I look at it, as long as Mercedes is running up front, I don't care who it is. Because what I'm looking at is not the driver's championship. I'm looking at the constructor title. The title that Mercedes has held consistent for, what, 5 years now? That's right? 4 years? 2014? Yeah, I'm gonna say four to be safe. If they get it this year, which, if they keep up this 1-2 finish, they'll clinch early on that. Sorry, my chat has decided to stop auto-scrolling. Bottas still has the best team radio of this year. To all who it may concern, fuck you. I heard about that. Oh my god, that was funny as hell. That was funny. Because, like... But think about this, though. Look at what Bottas did during the off-season. He rebuilt himself. So, in of itself, he worked for what he's getting right now. Yeah, that's just... Because everybody was saying that Bottas was not going to be coming back. But if he didn't do some of the things he didn't do... If he didn't do the things he did during the offseason this year, he would not be up in the front. Competing with Lewis. Like... Is it pissing Lewis off? No, because he's actually having a very good fight. And Bottas is a very good racer. If anything, Lewis wants to see Bottas get a championship. But again, he's not going to just hand it to him.
rest of the grid is forming up, be patient and watch for the lights.
Well, at least we'll no longer get Ferrari fans calling Bottas the Lewis dog. Yeah, I agree. Hamilton, go. For the moment.
Start was okay, now stay alert for threats around you.
There we go. Back out in front. Not the nicest way I could have done that, but thank you very much for the volume. It's so very much appreciated. 66 laps. Oh god. Where these guys are going to be is in that last sector. In terms of lap time. Because like the last sector is my weakest and I really hate it because like I want to be good around this track in every sector. No, I think I'll stick with my original plan with Monaco. I think I'll do that. The week they're at Monaco, I'll be running short Monaco because I just want to win there. And
great work.
Then I will be running the full race in Canada on the same day. And the only reason why I'm not going to run the full Monaco, so everybody's aware, the last corner. The last corner before the front straightaway. That corner.
Good job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far.
I lose too much time in. To the point where even on hard difficulty I wouldn't be able to win the race. Let alone get pole. But during the race, I do go quiet because I'm focusing on my points, so I do apologize, but, you know, 66 laps is a long time. I'm gonna have to look at my R&D section and see what Red Bull is beating us. Because Red Bull is running right along with the Hamilton. I'm not liking that. I mean, I like the competition, but I'm not liking that from my perspective of my 1-2 finishes. Thank you again for the follow, dude. It's so much appreciated. Like I said, I do these races on the weekends that, well, at least right now, on the weekends that have fun races. When my dad's baseball season ends and we're still going through the F1 season, I will be changing it to probably a Monday stream. Will be when it happens. But I'm very glad to see Bottas and Hamilton 1-2 again in Barcelona, which, all things considered, you can look at my sub and almost see column as a prediction for the top two. Just replace my name with Bottas and, you know, whatnot. Honestly, as long as someone is beating Ferrari, I don't care who it is. I just don't want Ferrari beating the top dogs while Vettel is there. Like, uh-uh.
Teammate by 17.7 seconds.
couple laps here.
We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the softs.
Although, according to this right now, I'll drop to third. Now it's down to second. Nearly 10 seconds. 10 laps in already. Like I said, the one thing I like about this track is that it is a very, very fast lap time. Now it says first, okay. Yeah, my turn where is definitely an issue. I mean, I'm not really feeling it. I'm just kind of getting my points. Exiting the corners at the wrong points sometimes. Wow, that Williams is really slow. The one that's in the one that I'm really catching up to. That Williams is very slow. I actually have a career where I'm actually a Williams driver. Trying to bring them up. Of course, in that career I'm running, I don't know why it's easier difficulty because I know for a fact on hard I would not be able to do what I'd be able to do.
Now.
Beautiful pit entry speed, everything was a very, very clean entry.
Only one stop to go, one stop left in this strategy.
to save as much fuel as I can. I need to make the racing line just a little bit more vivid on the dynamic track side, just so you can clearly see where the cars have ran over, because it's really hard to see it. You can kind of see a darker area, but it's not as vibrant in the coloring as you would hope.
Lewis is in for a stop. Gap to teammate behind is 9.5 seconds.
I am trying to save a little bit of fuel here. Just a little bit. Wear and tear on the engine and stuff is getting worse and worse. I mean, have you played this game? How high have you let some of these percentages get before you start changing parts? I'm really kind of curious how far people have pushed the engine to. Because, like, right now, the farthest I've pushed it to is what you see on my freaking damage. I mean, 50% on my gearbox is ridiculously high. Because the bits I'm looking at replacing right now is both the turbo and the main engine itself. Because, I mean, they've ran nearly, you know, I'll probably change them if I can do it. I'll probably change them after Monaco and shit. So that way the gearbox, the turbo, and the engine are all brand new to start Canada. weird tire wear on this car so far. On my tires so far. That costs me time. That's where I'm gonna start letting off, is like right in that green section when it starts. To save fuel.
We're leading our teammate by 43.5 seconds.
Remember what I said? That's the corner where I can spit out and lose a lot of time very quickly. I mean, that was one time and like... You saw how much ground I lost. It was a fun ride though. Definitely was a fun ride. Like, I knew I could save it though. If you want to know why I spun there, I literally just tapped the brakes a little bit to try to stop it from spinning, and I actually spun it that way. So I actually prevented the amount of the spin.
Caution.
Magnuson.
Green flag.
Wonder who spun him. I wonder if he spun himself. Got a little bit out of the groove a little bit. Wait till this straightaway. away. That's why you saw me brake a lot more there. Again, right here, I will wait. Oh. Or I won't, because Erickson gave way and actually gave me room. That was a hell of a save, though, by me. What we're gonna do to save a spin from happening? Like, you saw the back end got swirling. Like, I was sideways. And now the lap traffic run begins. And it looks like Hamilton has created a gap between him and the Red Bulls now, so I'm a little bit happier to see that. I don't mind getting stuck behind him for a little bit. I just don't want to run into him. Because I have damage on, which means wing damage if I hit him. That's why you'll see me over break a little bit when they're in front of me at close distance. Take a look at this, though. If you look at it, you got Alonso and Force India, 5th and 6th right now. When have you seen McLaren up that high? Like, normally they're towards the bottom of the top 10 if they are in the top 10 at all. But see, my thing is if Ferrari was smart, they would have never gotten rid of Alonso out of Ferrari. They would have made sure to find a way to keep him.
Okay, we're not seeing any issues with tire wear right now.
But no, they wanted their pretty boy Vettel instead. And that's inevitably what it was. It wasn't Alonso wanting out.
Gap to teammate behind is 43.9 seconds.
Raikkonen and Leclerc's swap there was literally because Vettel didn't like Raikkonen. And because they want to keep their pretty boy happy instead of actually trying to win a championship. And yes, I call Vettel their pretty boy because he's the one that's the top dog, always will be. And there's no reason for that when you know that Leclerc can clearly beat him left, right, and center. Every single goddamn race. Also, if Ferrari would stop getting stupid with their pit strategy, maybe they would win a race. Okay, tip, if you notice that your car is starting to get a little bit slidey in that corner, general tip, let off the throttle, because the power of these cars goes to the rear wheels, so get off the power, and let the car kind of settle itself back in line. I still can't believe it that these things can do 200 miles an hour and they're just a V6 engine. Twin turbo, I mean, but still. I can't believe we're already 25 laps into this. God, it's going quick. Thank you. I may wait on my pit stop, by the way, here, just to wait for my teammate to pit before me. Under braking. I'm letting off right now. And let off a little bit early, but it's fine. Yes, it cost me more time to save fuel than, does to run full out, but I don't necessarily want to lap the whole field either. Which by saving fuel right now is going to prevent that by a lot. Just coast down into this corner. But it just coasts into this corner. Just kind of, I'm trying to just play the fuel just the right way. Because I like trying to have at least a lap of extra just to be safe. And also, I gotta practice my fuel saving techniques anyway, just in case if I get rushed up with rain or something like that. Or Singapore with rain. Because for some reason, this game thinks that you're going to use more fuel than you have in your car when you hit rain, which I don't understand. Has ever dubbed that, Ricardo? My god, Ricardo Fermi has the same luck that he has in real life. The worst.
Yellow flag. Okay, clear.
I mean, like, shoot, Ricardo is freaking, on Renault, and he still is struggling. I mean, like, has he even finished a race yet? I think he finished the last one. Again, there's me spinning at that same corner twice in a row and losing a shit ton of time because of it. And I'm not doing that intentionally, by the way. It could be.
Plus one lap of extra fuel. Fuel target, plus one.
Of 66 laps. Well, technically 67. Or if you're like me and like to call the formation lap zero. You know. What it technically is, they cross the start-finish line. They start on the grid, they cross the start-finish line. Come right back around the track once. In my opinion, it's lap zero. It just doesn't count. Although I wish if you ran the formation lap, I wish they would let you actually drive all the way to the grid and grid up. Instead of, at least for me, the game takes over. I kind of wish that wasn't a thing. to give me that weird way for me to lap him there. Which one of the Ferraris is this? Is this Raikkonen or is this Vettel? Because if it's Raikkonen, I try to be nice to Raikkonen as best I can. Because I have a lot more respect for him than I do Vettel. Anybody else waiting for Raikkonen to get his sweet revenge on Vettel and take him out in one race? Just one? It's Raikkonen. Thought it was.
Lewis is in the pits.
Wow, Lewis actually did pit before me. Wow. Interesting tire choice by him. What? Fuck it.
We're approaching the pit window. Be on the mediums.
Fuck it, why not, right? I haven't ran the medium as much this week, this race weekend.
Okay, we can take you this lap. Speed now. Let's get some heat into those tires.
Every other weekend, pretty much. Right now. And it will be pretty much every other week, regardless. Except during August, where they have the 3 weeks off. Until they started changing everything, including their point system, where their original point system, if it would have stayed, Junior would have won 3 NASCAR Sprint Cup championships or Monster Energy championships. He would have won 3 with the old point system. Confirmed by a website called J-Ski. He used to put up all the standings from the old point system, the new point system, you know, the in-betweeners, the two, like the break up one, the next L1. Although they were the same point system, pretty much. The Winston, the next L, and the Monster, he always does them every year. Normally. At the end of the year, he calculates it all out, and three times when he did all the calculations, Junior won the championship with the old point system. Because the old point system was based on consistency, not fucking wins. One thing that F1 has right is that it is about consistency. Winning one race doesn't mean shit. Winning six or seven, now you're talking a possible championship. But it's also, you know, that's why I DVR every single race. Except when they're, you know, in Canada, in Mexico, in Brazil even, in America. Even England, because of the time difference. There's a few Europe races that are put at just the right time. For us over here in America because of the time difference. Yeah, Dubai's a good one. I love Abu Dhabi though. Abu Dhabi is like my absolute favorite track because it's just the perfect track to end the season on. Like, when you see that race and you see the yachts on the one side and you see all the people, the crowds, the fact that in F1 they're the only motorsport that actually packs the seats outside of motocross. Also, yeah, I don't have time to watch a 4-hour NASCAR race. No, thank you. I'd rather watch the hour and a half to 2 hours at most for F1. If they televised more GT, they don't televise a lot of GT racing, which is my problem with it. They televise F1 to shit. Yeah, some of the races are not optimum times for us in America, but that's, you know, F1 wasn't started in America. But they're talking about adding another two tracks to the American side. No, seriously, that's a true statement. They want to add another track to the American run. The GT series is streamed on YouTube, yeah, I do know that. I prefer F1 because, like, it's, you know, actually have a fan base that's dedicated. Every little change that you see on this car has been requested repeatedly by either fans or by the driver. The halo, even though it was against all the driver's wishes, after Belgium of last year, every driver understood exactly why it existed and immediately changed their tone. Go look up Belgium Grand Prix highlights and you'll see what I mean immediately. And you watch freaking, was it, Hulkenberg that landed on top of Leclerc? Right on the halo. So if you take the halo away, the guy's dead. So it's like, you know, at that point, can you really bitch about it anymore? No, because it saved a life, which was what its job was to do. F1 was not expecting it to do that. Its first year implemented, though. Okay, let me ask you this. Would you prefer IndyCar over F1? I sure as hell wouldn't.
Showing small signs of wear, power output will be down.
Wow, that's the first time I've actually got into that. And yes, if you're wondering, yes, I am intentionally running slower in front of the Ferrari, intentionally. Big mistake, Vettel. Big mistake. Vettel, you're supposed to give way, you piece of shit. Jackass. Thank you. in past to battle. Intentionally. Won't be able to hold that up for much longer. Trying to let Verstappen build a gap between battle, because I don't want battle on podium. Thank you. trust me, I'm well aware that Hamilton is actually catching up to me by me doing that. But I have a huge lead, so I'm not really too concerned about that. Right now, my goal is slowing down.
Target is plus one. Faster engine modes are available.
By the way, I'm not blocking at all. I'm just basically giving myself enough power to just keep me in front of them. When Verstappen passes this lap car, I will be pushing to get around Verstappen. Until then. Thank you.
fastest lap of the race. Keep this up.
Oh, I can't believe I ran a faster lap that lap. And the lap car is doing exactly what I was hoping. Holding up Vettel. That lap car gave way very, very easily. Wasn't the most opportune time for that lap car to give way, but I would need a lot to go right in order for me to catch my teammate to lap the field. But the whole point of me holding up Vettel was also partially to prevent me lapping the whole field. Again, it's me improving that last sector. That's the only reason why I'm doing it any better lap time. Thank you. spend the last 10 laps in this camera, because why not? I'm not really much, so.
Is looking really good. You're managing it well.
Okay, I'm not spinning out again. Not. No. Yeah, we'd still have to gain way too much on Hamilton to lap him. Thank you. But if you want to think that I'm pushing as hard as I can to catch him. Every corner right now is vital that I nail it.
Five laps of fuel remaining. is your final lap. Final lap of the race. Work, that's P1. Race win. Well done.
Number 5.
So as I say that, we can see the drivers coming out now to collect their trophies. It's yet more silverware to take back to their base in Brackley after another excellent Grand Prix. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. The captain increases their championship lead. Moving on to the driver of the day then.
Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
Well, after a drive like that, it's got to be Charles Leclerc, hasn't it? Very clean, very smooth. He can be really pleased with that one.
On to the constructors then. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings.
Yeah,
meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position.
Sure.
A strong weekend from them as they fight their way towards the top. After all that excitement, it's time for a...
Great workout there today. How do you think it went? You took the top points today. Was it a comfortable win? You must be happy with the result today. That was an epic battle today. How do you think this will play out? Appreciate your time.
Work this weekend. It was fantastic to see you up on that podium. We've received invitations to new historic events. You'll be able to choose whether or not to participate before the end of this weekend.
All right, now to set up Monaco. I have to do it this way. I know a lot of people are going to be against me doing this, but I have to do it this way. Because if I don't, I'll regret it later.
The new parts have arrived from the factory without issue. They'll be fitted to the car in time for the next session.
Your reputation with the team depends on a number of factors. Conduct on track, interview responses, and whether or not you're satisfying your current contract terms. The higher your reputation with any given team, the more we'll be able to push for in contract negotiations.
When I do Monaco, I'll be doing Canada as well, so that's the plan. Also, I have no plans to do any R&D that weekend. That'll be straight to qualifying, straight. Just one solid lap. Hold the pole off the start of the race, and then just nail the track the few laps that I have to go around it. But that is not for today. That will be for another day in 2 weeks. So that will be all of that. I'm going to tear this all down and then boot up Destiny and go from there. Yeah. So I do hope you enjoyed F1. That was another very, very good race by me. I'm literally running Monaco just so I could get the goddamn win. That's it. I want to get the perfect season. Again, please feel free to tune in 2 weeks when I do both Monaco and Canada. So alrighty. Again, actually, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna briefly cut the stream so I have a separate video for this bit. And then,